is dishonest with very little will also be dishonest with much. So if you have not been trustworthy in handling material wealth, who will trust you with the true riches? And if you have not been trustworthy with someone else's property, who will give you property of your own? No one can serve two masters. Either you will hate the one and love the other, or you will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve both God and money. May God bless the reading of his word.
Amen. Thank you, Ellie. Well, today I've really been thinking about, of course, this week, really, in the last few weeks, been thinking about all the young people, the children, the parents, the teachers, the administrators who are going to be starting back on school this week, that this is going to be a whole different week. Some of you are going to be going to the school for the very first time. And some of you are going to be going back to school. You were at last year, for the last several years. But this is going to be the beginning of another school year for us. And I just wanted to let everybody know that you will all be in my prayers. And let's keep each other in our prayers during this week. Because there's a lot of joy going back to school. There's a lot of fun about it. But there's a lot of tension, too. Sometimes some frustration. And we have to be able to deal with that and get over that as well. And what a great lesson for life that is. And, you know, getting these kids ready for life, and that's part of what life is, too. And that's one reason I think the idea of faithfulness is so important. It's really, we talk around it a lot here at church. We don't mention the word specifically, but well, we do sometimes, but often we don't. But it's really what we're talking about when we talk about living a Christ-like life, living a godly life, trying to be the people that God created us to be. What we are talking about is about faithfulness. We want to be faithful people. And we think about that in terms of God. And absolutely, that's the most important aspect of faithfulness in our life. How can we be faithful to God? But as we're thinking about that, that also reflects on and is important in all the aspects of how we are faithful to one another. And that really inspires me. I mean, faithfulness to God, absolutely, that's very important. But how rare it can be and how important it can be to find those in your life who will be faithful to you. And what a grand aspiration it is to be faithful to others. When we think about faithfulness very commonly when we're in romantic relationships, of course, and that kind of faithfulness and how absolutely crucial that is and important that is, because it leads to one of the most beautiful things you can have in a relationship, which is trust. You know, faithfulness leads to trust, and how wonderful it is to be with somebody that you can trust. But it's not just true in romantic relationships. I love the idea, and I aspire to be a faithful friend. Faithful friend. What a blessing that is to have faithful friends in our life. To be a faithful friend to others and to have them in our lives as well. I want to be a faithful child, son probably would be a better word now, to my parents. I want to be faithful to them as they have been faithful to me all of their lives. I, of course, want to be a faithful husband. I want to be a faithful minister. I want to keep the trust of those that I work with and work for. Again, the idea of trust. That's one reason faithfulness is so crucial in the relationships we have, because when we're faithful, we build up trust, and when we're not, we can lose it, and boy, it's hard to get back. It's hard for anybody, right? Once you haven't been faithful in some way, it's hard to get that trust back and to earn it back. So how important it is we think about that all the time. We be faithful friends, and faithful family members. And it's actually one of the great things that we're called to do as Christians, is to be faithful, because we're called to be like God, we're called to be like Christ, and that's one thing that God certainly is. God is faithful. God says it, that's one thing it says in Scripture over and over again, and talks about is the faithfulness of God. And what is that? The idea of God being faithful is the idea that, you know, when God created this world and made it, and hope that we would all look at the world and the beauty of it, hope that the people would look at God and see how God had made this place for us, and that we would respond by being obedient to God. course, that's not the way it worked out. We didn't respond by being obedient to God and looking to God. We responded by turning away from God so much of the time. And so here God had this world, and really, this world that God had created, these people that God had created, and they are being disobedient. And what could God do? Well, one thing God could certainly do is say, I'm going to start it over. Throw this in the trash, start over again. I want this to be right. I want it to be okay. So he could have absolutely done that. But God did not do that, because God's nature is to be faithful. And even faithful to the creatures, those that he created. And so God, instead of God saying, you know, instead of starting over, instead of scrapping this world and starting anew, I'm going to solve this problem. God is faithful. And where does that faithfulness come? It comes from God's love for us. God loves us. And out of that love comes faithfulness. And actually, that's one of our lessons today as we think about our faithfulness. Well, that's something I want. I want to be known as a faithful person. Not just in my marriage, but in my friendships, in my work. Jesus, again, as I mentioned to the kids a moment ago, when Jesus talked about faithfulness, it was often talking about the master's relationship to the servant. And of course, that's an idea of us being, God being our bosses, but it's also an idea, too, that in this world, we need to seek to be faithful, not just to our friends and to our family, and to the, but also to those that we work with and work for. That there's faithfulness that needs to happen there as well. And I think this is something we can understand. I think it's something that we could all probably say, yes, I want that in my life. I want to be a more faithful person. I want to be more faithful to God. I want to be more faithful to others. How can I do that? Well, I love our scripture reading today has a great tip for us. And a great idea is we're thinking, okay, I want to be more faithful. That's who I want to be in my life. How can I do that? How can I be a more faithful person? And our scripture reading today reminds us that those who are faithful in little are faithful in much. So if we want to be faithful to God in big ways, you know, at those big moments and grand important times in life, we have to be faithful in the little ways as well. If we want to be faithful to our friends, in the moments of crisis that come, when they can really look to us and they know that they can count on us, if we want that to happen, and we want to be perceived as faithful in these big moments, then we have to be faithful in all the little moments that lead up to it, all the little needs, all the little crises that can exist between friends, and the needs that can come up between friends. To start with the little things. And that's something we can all grab onto, because, man, they come every day. We're in a relationship with so many people that this idea that their needs of us are going to come up every day. And actually, we can really be faithful, extremely faithful to others. Let's say those in our families, those we live with, those in our homes, when we start anticipating those needs. That is a real act of faithfulness, is if you have a friend or a family member or somebody you're living at home with and you start anticipating their needs, that is an act, a small act of faithfulness. Man, so small acts all built together that lead to something great. It's like the way the people that are into, you know, running, the people with the 20, I don't even know how long it is, 26.2, 24.6, whatever it is on the back of their car. How do they get there to where they can slap that sticker on their car? It's all the little steps they take. Each individual little step they take in training that leads to miles and miles each week that they're able to run, each of those little steps builds up and creates something amazing. That's what we need to do. We need to grab onto this idea that we don't have to wait till something great catastrophe happens or some great opportunity for service happens. We can be faithful to God every day. We can be faithful to each other, and we can show it to each other every day. And if we need a way to start with that, we just need to start the way God starts. Faithfulness starts with God, with his love. Faithfulness is an expression of God's love. So if you want to try to be more faithful to those around you, try to tap into that love that you have for them. Think about that love and let that love inspire you to do these things for them and to anticipate those needs for them, to be a faithful person and to do it not just periodically, but, you know, day after day. To be that kind of a faithful person that just continues to do it, regularly does it, has that willingness to stay focused on being faithful. You got to tap into that love. That's one thing Scripture tells us, and we'll hear it a lot of our songs. Great is your love, God, and great is your faithfulness. It reaches up to the sky. It's so great. Love and faithfulness, they go together. So, hey, if there's a part of your life where you're having trouble with faithfulness, and let's say what can happen with many of us is our work. You know, after a while, our work starts getting to us. We have trouble being faithful to our work and faithful to what we do and being in on time and doing the things we need to do and doing them well and getting an honest day's work for an honest day's pay and all that. Well, one thing we can do if we want to recapture that is make sure we tap into our love for it. Our love for our work. I mean, wait a second. Not all of us love our work. Right? Not all of us go to work each day going, oh, Brian, I can't wait to get to work and get busy and start doing these things. I feel that way. I'm blessed. Both my wife feels that way, which is wonderful. She wants to work with a great spirit. She wants to be there. But I know, too, that there are probably days I go to work and I don't feel that way. But I'll tell you, there are things I always love. And even if you don't like your boss, and even if your work is getting to you and the work that you do, there are things that maybe can inspire you to continue that relationship and to be faithful with your work. And one is maybe you love providing. Providing for yourself, providing for your family. And it's that love of providing for your family, your love of your family, that makes you faithful at work. A faithful work. Maybe it's just the love of being able to live in this home that you live in or to do this thing that your work allows you to do. You tap into that love for being able to provide, and that can help you be faithful in what you need to do. If you're having trouble being faithful with somebody in your life and being the kind of faithful friend that you want to be, examine that love you have for that person. Understand why you care about them, and then that faithfulness can come out. I think a lot of us, you know, we think about faithfulness and we think about the great heroes of the Bible. We think about these big moments of faithfulness and great challenges that come. And that's how we perceive faithfulness. It's like Moses, you know, bringing the slaves out of Egypt. That's faithfulness. Or Abraham and his life and his what he did and his life. That's faithfulness. These great big things. We've got to remember that faithfulness is something that happens each and every day. It's something we need to be on the lookout for, these opportunities to be faithful. And so that's what I want you to be thinking about in this week ahead. I want you to be looking at and thinking about and recognizing is that each and every day this week, the 7 days from now until we meet up again next week, you're going to have hundreds of opportunities, countless of opportunities to show your faithfulness to your friends, to your spouse, to your family, to your children, to your parents. You're going to have these chances, hundreds of them a day. And I want you to, at the end of each day this week, I want you to be able to lie down in your bed to get ready to go to sleep. And as you're thinking about your day, and perhaps as you're praying, that you can feel in your heart, because of all the actions that you've taken, because you've made faithfulness something that you're doing intentionally in your life, as you lay your head down, you're going to feel in your heart God's voice speaking to you. And as you think about all these things you have done, you're going to hear God saying to you, well done, my good and faithful servant. Let's bow in prayer. Loving God, we do ask that you help us to be faithful. Lord, this is such a grand thing to be able to reach for. Help us to be like you. Help us to be like your Son, Jesus Christ, who through his faithfulness to you died on the cross and made it possible then for us to be in relationship with you, made it possible for the rift between us to be healed. Loving God, help us to grab onto that kind of faithfulness in our life. Help us to commit ourselves to it so that we'll be known by those around us and we'll be seen by you as being faithful, and we'll bring glory not to us, Lord, but to your name. Lord, we give thanks that you've given us this chance to be in this worship service and to be able to feel inspired by you, feel strengthened by you, so that we can show our faithfulness and be prepared to be faithful in the coming weeks. Loving God, thank you for this table that gives us a chance to be able to receive these elements of bread and cup. this chance that we have to be nourished by you, and this chance that we have to be strengthened for this week ahead. Loving God, help us to feel your spirit with us as we prepare now to receive these elements of bread and cup. And Lord, as we prepare here and now to receive this bread, help us to be with us as we now pray these words that your Son taught us to pray. As we say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,